Hi, my name is Jerry Pinto, and one thing that no one knows about me is my real name is Geronimo Maria Bernard Matthew Luke Sebastian Augustine Pinto. Totally holy. And that's what's on my baptismal certificate. It's not on my passport. What's on my passport is Geronimo Maria Pinto, which leads many people to think that I didn't have a daddy. I did. His name was Augustine Pinto, as you might have read in my book, M and the Big Whom, which won the Crossword Award for Fiction and the Hindu Lit for Life Award. I did it because I got tired of telling the truth, and I decided I might tell some lies for a change. What is the difference between fiction and non-fiction, really? In both, you're telling stories. The best fiction reads like non-fiction. The best non-fiction reads like fiction. When you are working on non-fiction, you have to try and give it the drama, the action, the character analysis, the build-up, the tension creation, and the tension release of a story. And when you're working on a story, you have to make it sound like it's reality. So these two categories in the minds of a writer overlap with each other. We work on them together, where there is no separation, at least at the level of art. There is only separation at the level of craft, and there is separation at the level of realization. As in, when someone else reads your work, everybody has to agree that it's non-fiction. When you say it's non-fiction, it must be verifiable. Other people must be able to say, yeah, that's what happened, that's how it happened. When it's non-fiction, when it's fiction, you're free. You say what happened. You are God. You are in control of the world. You tell it like it is. Many journalists seem to think this is how they do their daily work as well, but never mind. Pictures and words are completely different. If you say, you know, that famous thing, a picture is worth 1,000 words, name 5 pictures which will measure up to the Constitution of India's preamble, the Lord's Prayer, Where the Mind is Without Fear, all of which are about 350 words and powerful words. Take 3 words, I love you, balance 500 pictures against that. I love you said with emotion and with feeling smashes any pictures that you want into the ground. Words are important and central, but words and pictures together perform a duet that is just incredibly beautiful. Every one of us started by reading comics or illustrated books, and that's where our heart lies. I remember Lewis Carroll's Alice in Wonderland. Alice is sitting next to her sister, and she says something like, she's looking into the book that her sister is reading, and she says, it had no pictures and it had no conversation, so she got bored and she fell asleep. Pictures and conversation. That's what comic books are about. So when I wanted to write a comic book about tolerance, about living together, about trying to work in harmony, I thought that the best way to do it would be to write a comic. So I wrote the writing half of the graphic novel, and I sent it out into the world, and everyone told me that was very nice, but they didn't want to do it until finally I came to Scholastic, where Shoyoni Boshu was like the head genie, the head scholast, whatever, and she could see what I wanted to do. And then she started the work. She got Garima Gupta involved, who was a magnificent illustrator. And then when I saw the first drawings that Garima Gupta did, I thought, hey, I'm safe. This is another narrative. It's a parallel text. Someone is saying something else. They're adding to what I'm saying. Together, this is a jugalbandi. It is more than the sum of its parts. It's wonderful. So that's when the graphic novel started. I'd love to do more graphic novels, but they are matha fodi. And parents who buy books for children are stupid idiots in India, and they only want to buy one more version of illustrated classic stories from our past, or they want to buy non-fiction boring books so that their children will stand first in class. M and the Big Whom was the first book that I ever wanted to write. It was the first book that I ever wrote also. I think in some ways it was an important book for me to write, because it was like a stone that I was carrying around, like a weight that I was carrying around, and I felt I had to put this weight down at some point by telling the story. Then people asked me, now you told the story, have you put the weight down? And I can't answer yes or no, but I can give you an image. When you're walking, when you're trekking, you're carrying a bag with a very heavy, you know, load on your back, and it starts cutting into your shoulders here, and then you put your fingers under the load and you pull it out a little, or you pull it in a little, and that part feels so good and released, but you know that another part is going to hurt soon. That's what life is about. When you look at Twitter, Twitter is a medium. It's a nice little flowing river. So sometimes this river is full of polluted, horrible, dirty things that people are saying, where they shout at each other and they abuse, and you feel angry and sad. And at other times it's a nice mountain stream full of interesting fish and nice little animals and popping lotuses floating on the top of the stream, and you love it. So I don't think one can look at Twitter as a medium. It can't be blamed. The medium can't be faulted for the use that people put to it. It's like holding up a knife and saying, do you like a knife or do you dislike a knife? Well, I really like the knife when it is cutting my vegetables and making me a really nice meal. I really like this knife when it is slicing into my friend and taking out a malignant tumor that is lurking inside him. I really hate this knife when it is turned against some innocent person's throat and cut, but that's not the knife. I am my own funny act. If I want a funny act, I look in the mirror. That's all I have to do when I burst out laughing. And I think the funniest act that is perpetrated upon me was the face I was given, because inside this somewhere, I look like Richard Burton.